like to say why I'm here, tonight. That's to help celebrate 30 years of wrestling right here at the Louisville Gardens. See, I'm not just here because I'm unemployed. I'm here because this building means a lot to me. I brought my son here tonight. We drove up. I let him know that 12 years ago, I used to be here every Tuesday night. So we've been fortunate enough to see a lot of people in this ring, like Jackie Fargo, like Steve Kern, like Stan Lane, like Jimmy Cornette, who helped make Louisville Wrestling. And I can't say that I helped make Louisville Wrestling, but I sure as hell know that Louisville Wrestling helped make me. The WWF guys just don't come out of thin air. They worked damn hard to get where they were. I know that Kane worked damn hard to be in this ring. D'Lo, you worked damn hard to get where you are. Even Al Snow worked damn hard to get where he was. And we wouldn't be there in the WWF if it weren't for places like Louisville, Kentucky, where we could help learn and help entertain people around the world. So what I'm asking you fans is that when the WWF wrestlers go away, I sure as hell you keep coming. Because there's a lot of great wrestlers that worked here tonight who are not WWF wrestlers. And I think you ought to give them a big hand.
Kane and his partner, the Damage, are back to their feet. Kane grabs Conway for the chokeslam. Brain damage on D'Lo, and yes! And now, Mick Foley goes down for the count, the special referee, and wait, what's Boland doing in there? Boland has grabbed Mick Foley's hand, prevented him from making the count. And Foley looks at Boland, and Boland, only the guy that does his laundry knows how upset he is. Foley just nailed Boland. Oh, they've come from 24 states and two different foreign countries to the Rock and Rumble at the Gardens here tonight. And they came to see Sacco. And Kenny Boland's getting an up-close and personal look. Sacco on Boland. And now Kane, he grabs his man again. He grabs D'Lo. Damage with Conway, brain damage, choke slam. There's referee Robert Briscoe, senior OVW official. He counted it. And the team of Kane and the Damage have won. Thanks to Mick Foley and Robert Briscoe, Kane and the Damage are victorious. Kentuckian, and welcome to another exciting hour of Ohio Valley Wrestling on WB 34 Cable 7. You just saw Mick Foley's heartfelt speech to the fans at the June 23rd Rock and Rumble and the climax of the main event. But in this program, you'll see highlights of Al Snow versus Nick Densmore for the OVW title. Trailer Park Trash versus Flash for the Hardcore title. We're going to hear more on this Tuesday night's War Games at St. Teresa Gym. But right now, one of the most controversial athletes at OVW is ready for action on WB 34, and Dean Hill is ready with the introduction.
242 pounds out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Slick Robbie D. And his opponent.
Well, folks, he's the 22-year-old phenom of OVW with his partner, the Big Red Machine, Kane. He struck a massive blow to Boland Services at the Rock and Rumble. He's on his way to War Games this Tuesday night, and he's one of OVW's money ball players. Please welcome the Damage and Dean Hill with the official introduction to this capacity crowd.
232 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Damage. Robert Briscoe, your referee, no better way to kick off OVW on WB 34 than a wild match like this.
Oh, and I'll tell you what, and folks, for the Rock and Rumble highlights that we talked about, going to be all spread out throughout the program. You're going to see footage of so many tremendous things that happened, and we thank you very sincerely, as we always do, for allowing us into your home on Saturday nights on the WB34 Cable 7. We thank you for coming out and making Louisville Gardens the place in the country again to see live professional wrestling, to see the thousands and thousands. It just did my heart good because back when I was a kid, as many of you were Tuesday night wrestling fans, and we brought it back for one night. And there's going to be more. We'll talk about more upcoming Gardens events for OVW in the future. But right now, Robbie D and the Damaja, so competitive, so athletic. Nip and tuck here, and the Damaja with a lateral press. Count of two and no. Slick Robbie D comes out.
The Damaja is grabbing him right now, hooking him up in that headlock. My goodness gracious. Oh, ladies and gentlemen,
look at that maneuver.
The Damaja, I tell you.
Wait a minute.
Phenom here.
Count of two. Got him. Whoa, two. There. Started to count ahead of myself, Dean, but Damaja looked like he had planted Slick Robbie D. Damaja, what a chore in store for him. The War Games this Tuesday at St. Teresa Gym. 1101 East Kentucky Street downtown. Look at the agility. My God, the spring in the legs. Like coiled steel springs. OVW's team of the Damaja and Trailer Park Trash, Rico Constantino and Russ McCullough, will face Iron Man Rob Conway, Mr. Black, Mark Henry, and the Collector representing Bowling Services. And the rules are very simple. One man from each team wrestles for 2 minutes. At 2 minutes, the team that wins the coin flip sends another man in to make it two against one. Every 2 minutes, another man enters until all eight are in the ring, and then it's submission or surrender, and there's no disqualification. Who will win the War Games this Tuesday night at St. Therese? And the Damaja could be damaged goods after Robbie D gets finished by the time he makes it to St. Therese this Tuesday.
Right now, Robbie is measuring the Damaja, one fist after another, another one into the face, a third and a fourth. Robert Briscoe trying to get the Slick one off of the Damaja right now. He isn't going to get off of him for very long.
Oh boy, I tell you what, I couldn't believe the ovation that the Damaja received in the Gardens. Wait a minute, steps into that Russian leg sweep, blocked that belly-to-belly. Damaja with his partner Kane and special referee Mick Foley standing side by side at the Gardens at the climax of the Rocket Rumble. Something that's just this young 22-year-old phenom will never forget. And my God, he boosts Robbie D up and right down on his face. Damaja, he's going for low. Looks like he went for the inverted atomic drop. And Damaja now with an elbow, pressing the advantage. Damaja in there with so many big WWF superstars, and as all the OVW wrestlers did, he acquitted himself so well. There's a crossbody from the top. Count of one, two, and no. Robbie D once again with the resilience to come out of the press.
You gotta understand, Robbie D is a natural athlete, much like the Damaja, ladies and gentlemen. Uh-oh, the right across the ring, reverse, comes off, ducks
Whoa.
Under the clothesline. He's going for brain damage.
There's a knee in the gut. The knee in the gut breaks up the brain damage, and that's the Damaja's move. That hanging tree choke slam, nobody's got to loose from it. Wait a minute. He's got it. Brain damage. Brain damage. Robbie D's
Man.
Been brain damaged. Ring the bell. If you ask the folks that know him in the locker room, Robbie D's been brain damaged for a long time. Well, I'll tell you, folks, amazing footage from last week's television program. You want to talk about War Games? We had an impromptu War Games situation last week where all hell broke loose. Let's take a look at that footage right now. And Damaja just never gotten even with Mr. Black. Black, the man, single-handedly and stole the OVW heavyweight title away from the Damaja. And Damaja now with the opportunity to get even. There's the big Damaja splash in the corner. And Conway is reeling. Damaja goes for the brain damage. That's his move, but Conway breaks it up. And Dinsmore back in Conway's face. Crony is climbing to the top. Crony's off. He nails Black. Damaja moved out of the way. And now Damaja throws Crony into the third row. And it's all Black and Damaja. Brain damage. Brain damage. He's got him hooked. The referee sees it. One, two, three. Ring it. Ring it. Damaja and Dinsmore. Damaja and Dinsmore win. Bowling Services has lost.
Man, ladies and gentlemen, now Crony is grabbed by Nick Dinsmore. Bowling's in the ring. He's got the briefcase all over the back of Nick Dinsmore, the Iron Man working on the Damaja.
Well, I'll tell you what, they can do what they want right now. They can do what they want with their advantage in numbers. They can do what they want with their weapons and their briefcases and their loaded gloves and their law enforcement batons. They can do whatever they want, but they can't erase the record book. On this night, Nick Dinsmore, Mr. Wrestling, and that Damaja, they beat Bowling Services. They were just that good. And now there's Trailer Park Trash. Trash is in the ring. Trash is swinging like a buzzsaw. Trailer Park Trash is everywhere. My God, who's going to stop him?
Trailer Park, oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, the collector from behind Graham's Trailer Park. Man, everybody in Bowling Services is making their way out here.
The collector all over the top of Trailer Park Trash. He was trying to save his fallen comrades. But now Trash 2, a victim of the numbers advantage. And now Collector.
Rico!
And he knows that he's got to keep swinging before he goes down. There's so many of them, it's a do or die situation. But Rico's nailing everything in sight. And there's Mark Henry. Oh my God, Mark Henry, the world's strongest man.
My goodness, ladies and gentlemen, everybody's in this ring. Oh, the big Russ McCullough! Big Russ McCullough!
And McCullough! McCullough's here to even things out. The size is on the side of OVW. And I guarantee you, it's like a mini war games right here. OVW Independence Day. It comes Tuesday night, July the 4th, St. Teresa Gym. And by God, we're going to let off the brakes. And all hell's going to break loose on the 4th of July.
Welcome back to the OVW, ladies and gentlemen. Obviously joined here in the ring by Bowling Services. Things weren't quite as triumphant at the Rock and Rumble as what you would have preferred for them to be.
Are you out of your mind? Didn't you have a front row seat down there? Didn't you see it was a great night for Bowling Services? Because isn't it any wonder who won the Battle Royal? It was Jerome Crony!
Are you kidding me? He was passed out unconscious in the corner. Was Sexy Sean Casey, Chris Michaels basically took each other out of the match. This guy won it was by an accident.
Don't worry about Crony. Crony's going to be fine. As a matter of fact, we'll get a couple of Band-Aids, patch him right up. Don't worry about him because great things are coming for Bowling Services, baby. Great things are coming. Shut up, you rednecks. Great things are going to be coming for Bowling Services because it's going to be War Games. War Games is going to be coming because there's a certain balding matchmaker. There's some certain referees going on around here that have a conspiracy against Bowling Service. Well, it's going to be rectified at War Games because it's going to be the Iron Man Rob Conway. It's going to be Mark Henry, Mr. Black, the Collector. We're going to be the force taking on Trash Damage. It's going to be that stupid Rico and that big retarded football player, Russ McCullough. Well, when we beat them and leave them laying in a pool of their own blood, there's going to be nobody that can take us on. There's going to be nobody that can stop Bowling Services from taking over.
Are you going to have a team captain?
The team captain is going to be, because every great war has got to have a great general. And I'm assigning the Iron Man, Rob Conway, to be the general to lead us into battle at Bowling Services at St. Therese.
You know the rules, Dean. One man from each team will start the match. Every 2 minutes, another man will enter. When all 8 men are in the ring, that's when the games begin, because it's either submission or surrender. And when we win the coin flip, we're always going to have the advantage of one extra man in the ring. And we'll use that advantage any way we want to, and nobody can stop us because it's no disqualification. So Ohio Valley, bring your best talent. We're going to cripple them. Then BS will be running this very show.
July 4th, St. Therese War Games. We'll be back right after this. Welcome back to OVW, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks again to everyone that joined us June the 23rd at the Rock and Rumble.
I tell you what, the biggest Gardens crowd in many, many years saw a lot of great matches, and none better than the contest for the Ohio Valley Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. WWF superstar Al Snow challenging our own Mr. Wrestling, Nick Densmore, the franchise of OVW. You are not going to believe this incredible action. Check out these highlights.
Now, Al Snow, I am Mr. Wrestling, but if you want to come out here and you want me to be Mr. Sports Entertainment, I'll be whatever you like. Because with a WWF official, and when I beat a WWF superstar, the people in the head office of the WWF will finally realize that it is truly all about me.
I don't give a damn whether you're Mr. Entertainment, Mr. Excitement, Mr. whatever you want. The only thing you're going to be after I get done with you is just like every single one of these people, and that is Mr. Loser.
Oh!
Cross sends Snow across. Snow with reversal. Dinsmore hits the turnbuckle, raises the foot. And my God, there's a power slam by Al Snow. One, two, no. Boy, I tell you, the pressure on Dinsmore here. Al Snow has been to the big stage. But Nick Dinsmore, this is his biggest match to date. Face hit the apron. Dinsmore, monkey flip. Hangs onto the grip. Now a finger lock, test of strength. Snow with a leg grapevine. Dinsmore comes out of it. Dinsmore scoots in and catches Snow's leg. Snow underhooks the head. There's a cradle. One, two. Dinsmore overbalances. Wait a minute. Snow with a reversal. Two. These two guys point and counterpoint. Now Snow swings. Dinsmore ducks. Going for the backslide. And a low blow. A low blow out of the sight of referee Teddy Long. Dinsmore hits the ropes. Goes for, wait a minute, Snow was going for that wheelbarrow suplex, but Dinsmore rolled in on him, almost had the count of two, and Snow clotheslines him out of his boots. And now he's so deadly, Snow is so deadly with this wheelbarrow suplex right on the back of Dinsmore's head. Give and take through the whole match. And this, wait a minute, two, three, no, almost had him. This near-capacity crowd at the Louisville Gardens for the Rock and Rumble, seeing one of the greatest technical matches in OVW history. As Mr. Wrestling Nick Dinsmore has proven that he can stay toe-to-toe with the 18-year veteran WWF superstar Al Snow. Snow up on the top. My God, both men on the top for the superplex. And they land. Snow swings. Dinsmore, one of his own. Oh, they both connected. And my God, it knocked them both senseless. Dinsmore and Snow leaning against each other. Dinsmore spins around, Russian leg sweep. But I don't think Snow's had enough taken out of him. And he comes out. Dinsmore sends Snow across, goes for the drop kick. Snow converts into the powerbomb. Referee Teddy Long, one, two, no. The WWF referee didn't count three. Snow now going for his trademark moonsault and he nails it. Can Dinsmore come out of this? How much can one man take? And yes, Dinsmore. Dinsmore shoulders up. Dinsmore with a backdrop. Dinsmore mounting the offensive. Snow, wait a minute. He traps Snow, sends him down in a modified spine buster. And now the prelude to the German suplex will be the missile drop kick from the ropes. And Dinsmore fires. Snow turns sideways and elbows the referee on the way down. Now Snow's got head. Snow has got that head and he nails Dinsmore. And referee Teddy Long was still down from that missile drop kick and didn't see it. One, two, it can't end this way at the Rumble. No! Teddy Long has seen head. Teddy Long wants to know what the hell head is doing in the ring. And listen up, folks, behind the hometown boy, Providence High's own, OVW's franchise player, Mr. Wrestling Nick Dinsmore. Teddy Long and Al Snow having a tug of war. There's Dinsmore, German suplex. That's his move, two, three, he's done it. Dinsmore wins. Al Snow has been defeated at the Rock and Rumble by Mr. Wrestling, Nick Dinsmore. Dinsmore retains the OVW title in a classic. Ladies and gentlemen, he is fresh off the biggest win of his entire career in front of the biggest crowd of his entire career. He defeated a world-class athlete and WWF superstar Al Snow in defense of the OVW Heavyweight Championship belt. He's a homegrown boy all the way from Providence High School. Mr. Wrestling Nick Dinsmore, you are the man. You remain the man after the Rock and Rumble in OVW. But I have a piece of news that I'm not going to take up everybody's time, but I have a piece of news that nobody else here but me and Nick know. WWF Vice President of Talent Relations Bruce Pritchard was at the Rock and Rumble. So was his right-hand man, Kevin Kelly. The word got back because of the internet publicity and the photographers. And everybody in wrestling was covering the Rock and Rumble. And one thing came out of that match. Nick Dinsmore dropped Al Snow on his head. Nick Dinsmore pinned Al Snow, one, two, three. And Nick Dinsmore has now, one of our own, officially been signed to a WWF developmental contract. Nick Dinsmore is a contract player with the World Wrestling Federation, the biggest stage in the world, And when the time comes and the spot opens, then Nick Densmore is in line to be called up to full time. And Nick, I gotta say, you've gotta have a lot of emotions running through your mind, but you are just this close to being on Monday Night Raw, son.
It's been 4 long years since I walked into the OVW Training Center. I sat down in front of Danny Davis and I asked him to train me to become a professional wrestler. Now, when I walked in here, I had one goal: to get a WWF contract. I knew that winning this belt wasn't gonna give me a contract by itself, but I knew that this belt would be one step to making it to the WWF. Now, these OVW fans, they've stuck by me when I didn't even appreciate them. And Al Snow nearly beat my brains out at the Rock and Rumble, but I hung in there. I waited for my opportunity, I dropped him on his head, and I beat him. Now I am the OVW champion, and I have a WWF contract. I just wanted to take this time to thank each and every one of these OVW fans for sticking by my side, and especially to thank the man who trained me, the Nightmare, Danny Davis.
Well, it's been a long time in coming, and we've had the...
Look out! Look out!
What the hell's the matter with you?
Is it right?
What?
Let me tell you something. I went out there, I tore the house down, I damn near broke myself in half, I stole the show, I get screwed out of the Hardcore Championship by Dutch Mantel, and this no-good suck-up gets my contract. No! No! It's not gonna go like that!
Well, it did go like that. Maybe it's because your attitude. Maybe it's because you beat Bruce Pritchard up one time. Maybe it's because you won't leave anybody alone. Maybe that's why.
Shut your mouth. It's been 4 years. Well, let me tell you something. It's been 8 long years for me, you son of a bitch. And I'm going to tell you something. I'm not going to stand by and let this happen. I was sleeping in my car while you were in high school chasing those little cheerleaders. You were sucking up to Danny Davis. I paid my dues, and that was my night, and you stole my contract, and I want what's mine.
This is Nick Densmore's time.
Listen, for 4 years I've busted my ass, Flash. You can come out here and whine all you want, but the gist of it is, if you want a shot at this title, let's go at it, and you can find out why it is truly all about me.
Yeah, and in the meantime, maybe you can find out what...
Oh my gosh, Flash has jumped Nick. He didn't even see it coming. Oh, look out, Jim. Get it. Oh, no. He's hitting with some knucks, ladies and gentlemen. He has got knucks on his hand. Oh, elbow to Cornette. One for Briscoe. One for, oh, my goodness. Oh, dear Lord, ladies and gentlemen, Nick Densmore. Oh, my goodness. He's been laid open, ladies and gentlemen. He has been laid open. Oh, my gosh. Oh, Jim, look out. Flash has laid open Densmore. Oh, no. Oh, no. My God, now he's choking him with his own shirt. Oh, man, one fist after another using those knucks. Unbelievable. Flash has gone off the deep end. Look out, Jimmy. Look out. Oh, my God. Nick Densmore. Oh, no, ladies and gentlemen. He has laid open the heavyweight champ. Oh, look at that. He's taking the belt. He has taken the heavyweight title. Oh, my goodness, ladies and gentlemen. Nick Densmore has been laid open. The Ohio Valley heavyweight belt has been stolen. And if you ask me, jealousy has reared its ugly head. Listen, we're going to need to get some medical attention for Nick Densmore. Oh, my God. We'll be back after this. Oh, dear.
Folks, we're back here on Ohio Valley Wrestling. Wait a minute now, Nick. I got to apologize to WB34. I got to apologize to the viewers at home for the actions and the incidents of Flash. And Nick, I know that you're upset, but you got to calm down and you got to get some medical attention.
Upset? This is supposed to be the greatest day of my life. Flash comes out here, busts me open, and steals my belt. Flash, if you want to be champion that damn bad, you're not only going to have to beat me for my belt, you're going to have to kill me for it.
I guarantee you this. If you still want a match against Flash for the title, we can have one. Flash may have possession of the belt, but Flash is not the champion. Tuesday night at St. Therese, I'll put a match on for the title, and Flash will have to bring that belt. And if the man that wins carries the belt out, the best man will win.
Well, hell yes, I want a match. Flash, you say you've been beat on for 8 long years? Well, let me put it to you this way. Tuesday, I'm going to give you 8 years worth of beating all in one night.
Well, there you have it, folks. It's going to be Dinsmore and Flash this Tuesday night at St. Therese for the OVW title. Flash will have to bring that belt back. And good God almighty, right now, before we get a chance to clean up, the tag team title is in turmoil as well. Let's go back to the Rock and Rumble. The Disciples of Sin against the Pain Thrillers, and you'll see the tag team championship has changed hands. BJ Payne sends his man across, but Slash reverses. BJ catches up for the DDT, and my God, there's Sin. There's Sin, and she slapped BJ Payne right in the face. Judas has pulled the referee to the floor. Sabre and Damian are in a brawl, and BJ has laid hands on Sin. Sky high, little lady. He told you he'd sky high out of hell, and that's exactly what he did. And BJ Payne going for the frog splash as referee Nick Dumeier still on the floor, but Judas, Damien and Sabre in a Pier 6 brawl outside, and no, Slash pulled Sin away. And there was no water in the pool when BJ Payne landed, and now both the Disciples of Sin in the ring. There's a boost. My God, Damien caught him in a neckbreaker-like maneuver. And Slash makes the cover. The referee is making the count, but give the assist to that little bitch on the outside, because if it wasn't for her, the Pain Thrillers wouldn't have lost the tag team championship.
Welcome back to the OVW, ladies and gentlemen. You said the powers of Sin would prevail at the Rock and Rumble, but you can't be happy as the way it happened.
Since we have obtained the tag team titles, it is obvious that we wield the power of the netherworld. And the keeper of the gates of hell are already on his way to the realm of the living. Soon, we will be the most powerful force in the universe. Jude 23. The year 2000, a dark cloud has fallen over the OVW. Now to most people, that would spell the end of days, the end of time, doomsday, if you will. But to the Disciples of Sin, it spells a new beginning, a reign of terror, a reign of mayhem, a reign of blood, a reign of power, but most importantly, a reign of sin. Now, BJ Payne and Scotty Sabre, we offered you the opportunity to join with the greatest power of sin, but you declined. So we had to show you what it was like to fall at the knees of sin. Now, today, what I want to do is I want to degrade you even more, because we degraded you bad at Rock and Rumble. I want to degrade you even more, because a man that is this low, there's only one place he can go is up. And he's very susceptible to sin. So what I want to do today is beat you again. I want to call you out and give you another opportunity so we can beat you one more time and have you very susceptible to sin. And so you will join our side. Why don't you come out, Pain Thrillers? Why don't you come out?
Well, wait a minute.
Take a look.
While we're still trying to clean Nick Dinsmore's blood off the broadcast position, BJ Payne's got blood in his eyes. If you want him, you want to talk to him, here he is.
Shut up! You freaks want to defend the titles against the Pain Thrillers tonight?
Tonight.
Well, you know what? You've got it! Scotty hasn't shown up yet, but you know what? I know he'll be here. He's never missed a match. Now, back to you circus sideshow freaks. You guys may all worship the power of sin, but tonight we're going to teach you about the power of pain.
Well, there you have it. I think it's a real good idea. We'll have the tag team title on the line in tonight's show. You let me know when Scotty Sabre arrives, and the tag team title match will be in the ring. And right now, while we finish our housekeeping, the best thing for us to do is go to a break. And Dean, watch yourself when you turn your back to get out of that ring.
Welcome back to the OVW, ladies and gentlemen. Now, here on the WB 34 Cable Channel 7, we're glad to be coming into your homes. Now, we saw the title match from a little bit earlier from the Rock and Rumble, but ladies and gentlemen, that wasn't the only title that was on stake that night.
Well, that's right. The biggest Gardens crowd in years, as we said, saw some great matches, but we promised it was going to be a train wreck, the OVW Hardcore Championship, and I've seen kinder and gentler and less violent train wrecks. Trailer Park Trash, Flash, Dutch Mantell, the special referee, anything goes. Need I say more, but take a look. Well, folks, Let's just be honest. All here is Flash breaks a pool cue over Trailer Park Trash's back. One of these men may not survive this thing. Both of them have vowed to steal the show. Oh, my God. Both of them have vowed to hospitalize each other. There's that big, thick weightlifting belt. Oh, down again across Trailer Park Trash's back. This rematch of what happened last September made last September look like a quilting bee. But God, did you hear his back hit the floor? Trash pulling a truck hood out. Trash has the hood of a truck, but Flash with that garbage can just blasted him right in the head. And now Flash hanging on by inches. Trash with a sunset flip outside in and the back of his head on the car hood. There's a reversal, the ladder in the ring. That's a 12 to 15 foot ladder, and that's a super kick under the chin of Trash. Flash sends his man across, goes for the backdrop. Trash with a boot. Trash goes over the, oh my Lord. Oh, it bowed, but it wouldn't break. It broke Trash instead. Flash climbing to the top. Flash, what in the world can he come at? Elbow, oh my God, he almost beheaded Trash like a guillotine. And now the guitar that Flash brought out from under the ring in this hardcore rules match. Dutch Mantel, the referee, letting them play. Oh, the folks at the Garden's here in hushed silence as Trash is placed on that table that's bridged across the top ropes. What devilish, fiendish maneuver does Flash have in mind for the fallen Trailer Park Trash and Dutch Mantel? He said he'd let them go. There's no rules in this one. The best man wins. And Flash is going to try to powerbomb his man. He's got to be 10 feet into that ring. No, Trash stands up, a backdrop, and Trash goes the other way. He fell to the floor, to the concrete floor. Flash, with that chair set up, has his man in his scopes. Spring on the chair on the top and a senton right on the side of the head of Trailer Park Trash. Good Lord, that ladder, 12 to 15 feet in the air. And that's sitting in the ring, folks, and Trash is chasing Flash up. Flash has got to be close to 20 feet off the concrete floor of the Louisville Gardens as this near-capacity crowd sits with hushed anticipation. Oh, my God! No! No, my God, he's broke! He's broken his back! Trash pushed him off the ladder. He's broken his back! And listen. Oh, just listen to it. Trailer Park Trash is bending that steel chair with Flash's face. And now Trash takes off and hits the ropes. There's a clothesline, a man out of the chair. How much more can two men take than Trailer Park Trash and Flash? Now Flash tries to keep from going over. Grabs Dutch Mantel. My God, he nailed Dutch. And Dutch smacked him right back. There's a one, two, no. Dutch Mantel said the only rule in this match was don't put your hands on the referee. And Flash has already broken that one. Wait a minute, Dutch Mantel, he's going for Shoe Baby. That bull whip will stop a 900-pound bull and Trash. As Flash turned around, DDT'd Flash on that truck hood. And now Trailer Park Trash setting his man on that 8-foot table, climbing to the, good Lord, God only knows how far up that 12 to 15 foot ladder here in the Louisville Gardens. And it's getting louder and louder. But God, no, he's down on top of Flash. He has put Flash through that table. Make the count. Trash has done it. Trash is the hardcore champion. Good Lord, they gave you everything they had to give. There isn't anything left in their bodies that they didn't put on the line for you. Well, despite the obnoxious attitude of Flash, who has disrupted our entire television program and stolen the OVW title belt, the fact remains Flash and Trash, they set a standard that will be impossible to follow for anyone in the Gardens for years to come in that hardcore title match. And Trailer Park Trash, folks, is your new hardcore champion. Don't go away. We've got shoot wrestling when we come back right here on OVW. Well, folks, we're back here on OVW, a little bit worse for wear, and we've been joined again by one half of the Pain Thrillers, BJ Payne. And BJ, do you have an update on Scotty Sabre's situation?
You know what, Jim Cornette? Scotty Sabre's still not here yet. I don't know what's going on. I'm starting to get a little bit worried. But I'll tell you this, there's still time left on this show. So just give me a few more minutes, and I guarantee you there will be a match tonight.
Well, I know Scotty Sabre, I know he won't let you down. You have as long as you want, as long as we got in the program, you get back there and keep an eye out for him, and we will have a tag title match on the show. And right now, we've got action in the ring. Let's go to that. God, boy, I tell you what, he has dominated opponent after opponent each week on TV in these shoot wrestling exhibitions. The 1993 NCAA Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, and he's ready for action. The Collector, Dean, and that's your job.
Escorted to the ring by Thurston Throckmorton of Bowling Services, 333 pounds from parts unknown, the Collector. And his opponent, 226 pounds out of the great state of Minnesota, Shelton Benjamin.
And you know something, Dean? Maybe I'm just not living right at all, but we've been joined at the broadcast position by the largest active wrestling manager I know of, Kenny Bolin. And Bolin, what in God's name do you have business do you have up here?
Another fine job of matchmaking you've done today. What do you got, some goof, some jabroni down here? Sheldon Benjamin, Benjamin Shelton, whatever the hell his name is. Only good thing about him is that his initials are BS, and that'll be the closest he ever gets to us. The Collector has been knocking them off like flies. He's been killing people out here, and you got some jackass jabroni in here getting ready to get killed. I'm getting sick of seeing it.
Are you seeing this? The jabroni, I think, yeah, he just went behind the Collector and took him down, because Bolin, I know something that you don't know.
What?
You know the Joe Louis Bum of the Month Club? That's what you've been running every week on TV, bringing a bum. Well, Shelton Benjamin is a young man who just started training at the OVW Training Center. He was a high school wrestling All-American, a two-time state champion. He went to the University of Minnesota. The University of Minnesota is a two-time NCAA All-American.
I never ran.
And he was an assistant wrestling coach at the University of Minnesota.
I never read.
Look it up. You don't read because you can't read. The Cat in the Hat spells boo is not wrestling knowledge.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shelton Benjamin has just lasted the 3 minutes that Bowling Services.
What?
He has just taken $2,500 from Bowling Services.
You made the offer. You made the offer. $2,500 if you lasted 3 minutes, and $5,000 if you beat him. Wait a minute! He beat him!
Wow.
He beat him!
Woo.
Shelton Benjamin wins!
Five.
Shelton Benjamin wins!
Thousand.
Shelton Benjamin,
thousand.
The two-time All-American from the University of Minnesota that just recently came to the OVW Training Center, has defeated the Collector, not only for the shoot wrestling exhibition, but for $5,000 of Kenny Bolin's money. The Collector has gone down. He thought he had a ringer, and instead he had the whole damn bell. And folks, don't you dare go away. We'll be right back with more excitement when we come back with the TV main event. Welcome back to OVW, folks, and before we get to this next match, we want to take this opportunity to thank Terry Havens of A Catered Affair. She catered tonight for the television crew and the wrestling talent. There's two locations, Hubbard's Lane in Louisville and Spring Hill Road in Salem, Indiana, for A Catered Affair. Thank you, Terry Havens. Wonderful meal. And right now, we have action with the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, scheduled to take on Guido Andretti. And wait a minute, it looks like Mark Henry has something to say.
Cornette, let me get something to your head right now. You sit in here in your little chair and you play mind games with Bolden, and you expect me, the world's strongest man, to wrestle rednecks like this on TV for free? Well, I got news for you. It's not gonna happen. I forfeit.
What?
He forfeits?
I forfeit.
That me.
Hey, punk, hey. This is the only win you'll ever get over an Olympic caliber athlete like me. Now raise his hand.
Well, I'll agree with that statement, to be quite honest with you, that Mark Henry just made. The only win that Andretti will ever get. Oh, no, wait a minute. Oh, no, wait a minute. Mark Henry all over Vito and Guido. There's Vito over the top rope. My God, he just clotheslined Guido right out of his boots. Mark Henry, he claims he's too good to wrestle on television front of the Kentucky rednecks, as he says. Too good to wrestle for free when he's a world-class Olympic athlete. And right now, Robert Briscoe, powerless, to stop the world's strongest man from cleaning the ring out. And then Briscoe going running. I'll tell you what, while Mark Henry is on the loose, folks, we will be right back. Don't you dare go away. We've got the tag team title, the Pain Thrillers, the Disciples of Sin, and it's going to be a hot one. Don't go away. Well, a stranger, more violent crew you would not find anywhere, all led by the dark priest Judas. And that witchy woman with the whip, and Dean Hill is ready to introduce the brand new Southern Tag Team Champion.
Escorted to the ring by the dark priest Judas, and of course, Sin, at a combined weight of 462 pounds, they are the Ohio Valley Southern Tag Team Champions, / Damien, the Disciples of Sin. And their opponents.
Well, I tell you what, these four are people you wouldn't want to meet in broad daylight, much less in a dark alley. And I hope to God that, and wait a minute, I see BJ Payne going to the ring with no Scotty Sabre in sight. And I'm inclined to go along with BJ Payne and realize that Scotty Sabre has never missed a match. And that there has to be some reason for worry, for some concern as to why he would not be here. And I look at the grin on that young woman. How about your chances for domestic bliss with her, Dean Hill, huh? Boy, she's a real shrinking violet. What about that sicko with the dagger and Damien?
You know what? Scotty still hasn't gotten here yet. I don't know what's going on, but I know something's wrong. But you know what? You freaks aren't getting away that easy. I'll take on any one of you right now for the belts. Anyone. And if you guys can beat me, any one of you can beat me, then we'll forget about the title match on Tuesday night, and you guys can keep the damn belts. I'll take on any one of you.
I hope B.J.
Even
Payne.
Even your stinky ass.
I hope B.J. Payne doesn't have more guts than he's got brains.
Big man, I'm all about threesomes, so why don't you take on both of them right now?
Oh, she just slapped and he's got her. But no, wait a minute, there's Slash and Damien. And the referee signaled for it. Wait a minute, this is an official start of the match. And it looks like it's going to be a handicap match for the Southern Tag Team Championship. Slash and Damien, the defending champions, the Disciples of Sin, against the lone BJ Payne. And if that violence had not erupted, BJ was trying to challenge one or the other. But Sin stepped in, Sin the instigator. Sin, just like every woman, she'll instigate a fight, but then she won't stay there to fight it. Sin is the one who led the attack on the Pain Thrillers 3 weeks ago. She burned Scotty Sabre with some type of fireball on Wrestle Rock. Last week, she handed Slash a dagger to make a human sacrifice out of Guido Andretti. And then at the Rock and Rumble, Sin was directly the cause of the Pain Thrillers losing the Southern Tag Team Championship to the Disciples of Sin. But BJ Payne, my God, his guts. Lou, when his guts are as big as all of Chicago, where he's from, the former college football All-American, sends his man off, Slash ducks, there's Damien. One referee can't keep track of this. I don't know who tagged who. I have no idea who's legal. I do know that BJ Payne is at a serious, serious disadvantage and could be in serious trouble here as relates to not only the status of the Southern Tag Team titles, but as relates to his health and his career and his well-being. Because these Disciples of Sin have shown that they have no boundaries. There's not too far for them to go. That's been proven. You can tell by the way they look and the way they dress that they live this in their daily life. And I'm just scared and afraid and shocked that such as the Manson family in the 60s and the Guyana cult of Jim Jones grew, such as I'm afraid that if these perverted, disgusting animals were allowed to flourish and to propagate, then it could be the end of, my God, there's a count of one, two, no! Thank God, BJ Payne with the presence of mind, and BJ's gotta be fighting on instinct alone, gotta be fighting on guts, and gotta be fighting somewhere in the back of his mind. He doesn't want to let his partner Scotty Sabre down, Dean.
How in the world is this young Pain Thriller staying up? My God, ladies and gentlemen, he's making quite an account for himself, considering he's not just taking on two men.
No.
He's got the Dark Priest out here to worry about.
Sky high there.
Sin as well. Slash comes in to break the hold.
There is no way that BJ Payne can get any of his several effective finishing maneuvers applied to either Slash or Damien without the other man there to break up the pin.
Oh, my God.
And right now, A double team maneuver there. If only there was someone. If only there was someone who could come to the aid, to the rescue of BJ Payne. If only. No, wait a minute. There's Chris Michaels. There's Chris Michaels. Chris Michaels wants to take the tag. Michaels wants to take the tag. And the standing room only crowd at the Davis Arena want to see him get it.
Talking about just what the doctor ordered, ladies and gentlemen.
It double DDT. Double DDT. BJ Payne has created his opportunity. BJ Payne has opened the door. But the disciples of sin are between him and the promised land. The fresh man, Chris Michaels, and he got him.
Chris Michaels into the ring, box head, big punch from Slash, a couple of fists on his own, sets him up for the ride across the ring. Slash trying to reverse this and does. Damian's getting back to his feet at the same time.
Whoa! Look, wait a minute.
What?
I thought he'd spin it. No, Chris Michaels over-evolved, landed on his feet. Northern Lights, drop kick to Damian. And now Michaels back to Slash, sends his man across. Slash stops his man. And there's Damian. Going up to the top rope, they're gonna try that combination modified powerbomb. But Chris Michaels, he's tattooing him in the head. He grabbed Damian, hip toss off the top, and a hurricane run. Oh my God, can you believe it, from Chris Michaels?
Man, Chris Michaels and a boot right into the chin.
Damian, Damian out on the floor. Michaels has the sleeper. Wait a minute, what's that bitch doing? My God, she sprayed him in the eyes again. She's blinded Chris Michaels. BJ Payne has sin. BJ Payne, I don't hit a lady, but that ain't no lady. They came apart when they heard a slam. And BJ going for the frog splash. There's Damian, pushes him off. My God, what else can happen here? Wait a minute, there's more referees trying to get in the ring. Michael's thrown over the top rope. Michael's thrown over the top rope, and BJ Payne is all alone. And Judas produces that dagger.
Oh, my God, he's got the knife.
My God, they're going to make a human sacrifice out of BJ Payne. My God, they're going to cut his throat. Now there's trash. There's damage. Oh, folks, we'll see you Tuesday at the War Games. A tragedy averted here.